हेलो एंड वेलकम टू सेंट थॉमस इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल सूरत, स्टैंडर्ड 10th, एनसीईआरटी, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश फर्स्ट लैंग्वेज। फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट फ्लाइट टेक्स्ट बुक, पोयम 3, अ टाइगर इन अ जू, बाय लेस्ली नॉरिस। Before we understand the poem, let's understand more about the poet Leslie Norris. Leslie Norris was a prize-winner Welsh poet and a short story writer. He is considered one of the most important Welsh writers of the post-war period, and his literary publications have won many prizes. Welsh are the people who live in Wales, and Wales is a country of United Kingdoms. Before we understand the poem, I would like to ask each one of you, how did you feel staying at home 24/7 during this current lockdown? Many of us did not like staying at home. It gave the feeling as if we were caged. Just think about the animals and birds that are caged. And how do they feel? This poem is about a tiger, and the poet is giving us a broader view of what a tiger feels when he is in a zoo, caged, and about a tiger who is free in his own habitat. So let's understand the poem line by line. A Tiger in a Zoo by Leslie Norris. He stalks in his vivid strips the few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. Let's understand the difficult words and its meaning. Stalks, meaning follows. Vivid, meaning having deep bright colors. Pads, here it means the paws of a tiger. And rage means violent, uncontrollable anger. Here, he refers to the tiger. And when we read the first stanza, we can understand that the poet is talking about the tiger that is in a zoo. He stalks in his vivid strips. The tiger is following with his bright colors that are there on his skin. The color of the skin is bright with the strips, black strips that the tiger has. The few steps of his cage. Here we can make and understand that the tiger is in the cage and he has only few steps. That means the cage is so small enough that the tiger is able to take only few steps. On pads of velvet quiet. Here, pads, as I already said, are the paws of a tiger. And the paws of the tiger are soft, that of a velvet. Here, the poet had used the metaphor to compare it with a velvet. Velvets are a material, cloth material, which are soft and smooth. And the poet is telling that when he is walking around in the cage, he is very quiet. His footsteps could not be heard. And the last line, in his quiet rage, that means quiet and rage. He is at the same time quiet also and very angry. Means extreme anger is shown by the tiger. We know the tiger is an aggressive animal. Why is the tiger angry here? Maybe because he is in a cage, but he is not showing his angerness. He is quiet enough and he is walking around in this small cage. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass, near the water hole, where plump deer pass. Let's see the meanings of difficult words. Lurking meaning, remaining hidden so as to wait in ambush, and plump meaning rather fat. Here we can understand the tiger is in his own habitat. So, when a tiger is in his own habitat, the tiger's true personality is seen. It hunts for its prey, and before it hunts, it hides itself between long grasses and moves very softly. And it knows that he will find its prey near a water hole, or it may be a pond or lake, where most often many animals come to quench their thirst. So here the poet is telling he should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass. The tiger is hiding itself behind these bushes and walking very quietly through these long grasses, where a pond is there or a lake is there, and he is waiting for that plump deer or a fat or a healthy deer to pass. So if that particular deer or other animals come here to drink water, the tiger can pounce on this animal and catch its own prey. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. Let's see the difficult words and its meaning. Snarls makes an angry warning sound. Baring, exposing, uncovering, and flanks, a large sharp tooth, especially a canine tooth of a dog or wolf. Here you can see this sharp teeth. They are the fangs. Here the poet says that the tiger should be growling around the houses that are at the edge of the jungle. We may have seen dogs and cats, when they get irritated, they growl. In the same manner, here, he, that is the tiger, should be snarling or growling or giving a warning sound to the houses that are near the jungle's edge. Now here we must understand that due to our growing population, we have taken away the forest area. We have cleared the forest, the trees, for making our own houses and factories. And in doing so, these wild animals have lost their own habitat. And to find their prey, and while they were moving around, they come across these villages that are near the forest. And while they come near the forest, they come and they make an angry warning sound to to those houses or the people that are living near the jungle's edge. And when they come there, they show their white fangs and their claws, trying to terrorize or scare away the people that are living in those villages. But he is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars, stalking his length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Concrete meaning a building material made from a mixture of broken stone or gravel, sand, cement and water, which can be spread or poured into molds and forms a mass resembling stone on hardening. Our houses, our buildings, offices, everything are made up of concrete. Here, he, that is the tiger's cell, is made up of concrete. And he is locked inside that concrete cell. That is his cage. His strength behind bars. Here, the tiger's strength is behind the bars. That is, if we remove these bars, the tiger's strength can be known. For example, if we have to visit a zoo, and in that zoo, if there is a tiger who is caged in a concrete cell or maybe in a cage, we can go and stand in front of that tiger. We will show our bravery because we know that the tiger cannot harm us. But if the same tiger happens to meet us in his own habitat, we will run away from there. We know we cannot stand in front of that tiger. So the tiger is caged here, and that too in a concrete cell. And his whole strength is behind these bars. And what does the tiger do? He stalks the length of his cage. He walks from one end to the other. And if you visit the zoo, we know that when we go to see the tiger is not interested in seeing his visitors. He never pay attention to who is coming and who is going, but he will be walking around or lying somewhere or sleeping. So the tiger is ignoring the visitors that come to the zoo to see him caged. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Patrolling meaning keeping watch over. When we happen to visit the zoo, we have noticed that every zoo has a particular timing. And after that particular timing, the zoo is closed. And it is the duty of these patrolling cars or the police or maybe the security guards to make sure that no one or no human being is stayed back. If anyone is there, they ask them to leave the zoo. And it is also their duty to make sure that all the animals are inside their cage and the cage is locked properly. So here the poet is talking about the tiger, and he's saying that the tiger hears the last voice of these patrolling cars, and these cars come by night. So the last voice of the security guards or the security personals, he hears them at the night. And during the night, when these people come, it is their duty to make sure that the animals are there and the cage is locked. And in doing so, they have torch in their hands and they flash the lights to check if the animal is inside or not. And in doing so, when the light is flashed over the face of an animal, the ice shine. Their eyes are said to be brilliant eyes. And the poet has compared those brilliant eyes to the brilliant stars in the sky. Let's understand the rhyming scheme and the poetic devices of this poem. Here, stripes, cage, quite rage. The cage is rhyming with rage. So stripes, we'll put it as A. Cage and rage, as it is rhyming similar, we'll put B. And quite as C. In the entire poem, this is the same rhyming scheme for the entire poem. A, B, C, B. Poetic devices. In the first line, he stalks in his vivid strips. Stalks, the sound st is there, repeated in stalks and stripes. So it is alliteration. In the same way, on pads of velvet quite, here the pad is compared to that of velvet. A comparison is there. And it is metaphor. The rhyming scheme of the stanza, it is here shadow, grass, hole, pass. Grass and pass are same. So we'll put A for shadow, B for grass and pass, while hole we'll put it as C. So A, B, C, B. Let's see the poetic devices. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass. Sh sound is repeated in should and shadow. So it is alliteration. And here lurking and sliding are rhyming. So it is internal rhyme. Near the water hole where plum deer pass, were sound is repeated in water and where. In the same way, per sound is repeated in plump and pass. Again, it is alliteration. Let's see the rhyming scheme here. Houses A, edge and village are rhyming. So we'll put it as B and clause as C. So A, B, C, B. Let's see the poetic devices. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. Now, snarling is a sound. So if a sound is there, it is onomatopoeia. In the same way, we can see he and B are rhyming. So it is internal rhyme. Next, baring his white flanks, his claws terrorizing the village. Here, baring and terrorizing are rhyming. So it is again internal rhyme. The word his is repeated two times. So it is repetition. And here at the end, you can see the exclamation mark. So it means it is exclamation. The rhyming scheme, here cell, we'll put it as A, bars and visitors, they are rhyming, so we'll put it as B, and cage as C. Now let's see the poetic device. But he's locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars. Now here, concrete cell, as I told you, it is cage. So it is representing the cage. And therefore, when it is representing, it is metonymy. In the same way, his strength behind bars. Here, the strength of the tiger is behind the bars. And here, the meaning is exactly opposite, that the tiger is very helpless. Helpless when he is in the bars or when he is in the cage. So, if something very oppositely of what is being said, then it is irony. And here, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors, stalking and ignoring, they are rhyming, so it will be internal rhyme. Let's see the rhyming scheme here. Night, cars, eyes, stars. Cars and stars are rhyming. Night, we'll put it as A. Cars, we'll put it as B. Stars, we'll put it as B. Eyes, C. The poetic devices. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars. Voice. Voice of the patrolling cars or the security guards. So, the sound is produced. So, if it is about sound, it is onomatopoeia. Now, here, and stars with his brilliant eyes and the brilliant stars. Brilliant, brilliant. It is repeated. So, it is repetition. And metaphor, because the brilliant eyes of the tiger are compared to the brilliant stars. Until next video, keep learning and keep practicing. Thank you.